Hello everyone, today I will share with you the process of designing, manufacturing, and testing my high-performance inverter. This inverter has a continuous power output of 1500 watts to 2000 watts for 1 minute, and a peak power of 3000 watts. It has a maximum conversion efficiency of up to 94.5%. At full load, the efficiency is 92%. Thank you to JLCPCB for helping me with this project. JLCPCB is at the forefront of six-layer PCB technology, and they are offering free via InPad. This new technology minimizes errors during the SMT soldering process.
This is the soldering path of the chip. How would you route it? If the number of pins is low, you can route traces directly outwards. However, when there are many solder pads on the chip, it becomes difficult to do the fan out. So we drill vias to transfer the traces to other layers. Note that we first extend a trace from the pad before drilling the via. While routing becomes much simpler, you still need to route at least one trace from pad to via, so there can still be issues with pads being too dense or too numerous to route effectively. If we directly place the via directly on the pad, there's no need for additional trace before via. But this can lead to solder wicking away through the hole during soldering, causing defects or cold solder joints. Via InPad technology addresses these issues. We still place the via on the pad, but then fill it with resin and plate it with copper. The surface shows almost no trace of this, and soldering is as reliable as with a regular pad, saving on routing, optimizing board size, and also enhancing thermal conduction. If you're looking to optimize your routing and save time, you can take advantage of free via InPad service. Try it now and save time.
I received my PCBs after 1 week, and the quality is perfect. I used an EE55 transformer in this project with 10 MOSFETs. The power output reaches up to 1500 watts continuously without any issues. Here, I am installing gate resistors for the MOSFETs, which typically range from 10 to 47 ohms. Unlike other inverters on the market, I use a gate drive transformer, GDT, to drive the MOSFETs. In my experience, the MOSFETs run cooler when using this method. Next is the power filter capacitor. I used 4 electrolytic capacitors rated at 2200 UFF, salvaged from an old device. It's labeled Emerson here. I believe it's from a printer or a UPS. The capacitors have excellent quality and are compact in size. The high voltage capacitors are 2 and 20 UFF 450 volts, though 4 and 70 UFS would be better if you have them available. 10 MOSFETs are needed for this project. I use a push-pull configuration with 5 MOSFETs on each side. The MOSFETs I use are 80 NF70s, salvaged from old devices. You should use a large aluminum heatsink for this project. It doesn't get too hot, but good heat dissipation is always better. For the H-bridge, I use 18 N65 MOSFETs from ST. You can use different MOSFETs or IGBTs if you prefer. They all work well. Another very important component is the filter inductor. It determines the quality of the 220 volt output voltage. I'm not very skilled at winding inductors, so it took me almost 30 minutes to wind this one. I use AB glue to secure it to the PCB. I think silicon glue would be better, but I don't have any available. This is the power module and the PWM module. The power module will convert 24 volt voltage to 12 volts for other modules to operate. The PWM module will control the DC MOSFETs as well as provide protection functions. I use an EE55 transformer for this project with a primary winding of 3 plus 3 turns. I use copper foil with a thickness of 0.5 millimeters. The secondary winding consists of 50 turns of copper wire with a diameter of 1.2 millimeters. Before installing the SPWM control module, we need to check if the DC-DC section is working properly. If the circuit is functioning correctly, we should have 380 volt DC across the power filter capacitor and a 12 volt auxiliary power source. If everything is fine, you can proceed to install the SPWM module. This is the SPWM module PIT 002. You can use the EGS 002. They are exactly the same. Finally, my project has been successful beyond expectations. When I tested it with a 1000 watts load, the output waveform remains sine. The output voltage is precisely at 220 volts, and all components are cool. The efficiency reaches 94% at 2/3 load. This is one of my most successful projects. Thank you all for watching the video. If you want to buy this project, contact me via Facebook.